Hi guys, this is Kelly. Today we're going to talk about what companies are looking for when it comes to drivers applying for a trucking job, and also when it comes to recruiting process and pretty much whether you are fit for a company or not. So here's the thing, you know, you got your license, you know, you got your, you know, 1 or 2 years of experience, and you want to pretty much change jobs. So every company literally is different. You know, they have different aspects of doing their business. Every company pretty much wants the same thing, a safe driver, qualified, and that can actually work. Unfortunately, the bigger the company, the more problems they get. The smaller the company, the less issues they're gonna experience in the future. So if you're gonna switch from a large carrier to a small carrier, things will be dramatically different. Small companies, they will pick the best of the best. Why? Because they're not self-insured. Small companies, they have small amount of customers and they don't want to lose them because of ignorance or laziness from the point of a truck driver. So they try to pick the best qualified drivers, pretty much their profile. You know, they look at everything. They look at hygiene. They look at how, you know, if you're clean. So when you go through an interview, they want to see, you know, you're like clean, you know. They don't want nasty drivers showing up at their customers, and customer will be like, I can't believe this guy is working for that company. So, you know, hygiene is very important. You know, if you clean, shave, clean clothes. They don't want smelly people that haven't taken a shower within like 2 weeks. Second, they're looking for a clean license. So they're looking for clean driving record. They don't want any tickets, you know, major violations. When they start saying that you got a CSA points because you got a low pressure air tire or your turn signal doesn't work, then they look at that. And they judge you on that because it tells them a lot, right? So you have to use kind of common sense. So a clean record, hygiene is very important. Obviously, you're going to take a road test, so they're going to judge you based on how you take the road test. They want to see whether you are actually, you know, driving the right way on public roads. They want to know if you actually know how to back a trailer. A lot of guys, they say, oh, you know, I've been driving for 20 years, and you put them in a reefer, they don't know what to do, right? They don't know how to back in properly. They don't know how to do a pre-trip on a reefer. They don't know how to operate a reefer. So everything has to do with showing them what you do, not just talking. And that's how small carriers are. Small companies, they can't take the risk. Now, large carriers, to be honest with you, they really don't care. They'll take anybody. Why? Because one is they're self-insured, and second, everything is about profit. Example is, you know, their profit is, you know, $1 billion this year, and they calculate accidents would be maybe $30 million. They can take you with a bad record because one is they're self-insured, and second, you know, they look at you as a dollar sign. You know, you may get fired within 6 months after having a couple accidents, but at least they'll make money out of you. There's not a right way of doing business, but unfortunately that is the trucking industry and they don't care. So large companies, more likely you'll get a job easy with them. It doesn't mean it's gonna work out at the end or for a long, long period of time. If you're going from a small company to a large company, you got nothing to worry about, they'll take anybody. But if you're going from a large to a small, they are picky. The smaller the company, the harder it is because they wanna trust you. And the only way they can trust you is by showing them, you know, how many years you've been driving, whether you have a clean record or not. And hey guys, I was told that only 15% of you are subscribers. Why not make 100%? Click the button, subscribe, and keep watching. So the whole point is every company is different. They do things different. So you're gonna have to use common sense. They're gonna tell you what they expect from you, and you're gonna have to tell them what do you need. You know, every driver's got needs. And if the company is willing to work with you, they'll give you what you want. But also in return, you gotta provide what they want too. And they want for you to be on time. They want you to be honest. They want you to drive accordingly and not to violate any rules. Why? Because the 1980s and 90s are gone and everything's e-logs. And every time you do something, it reflects on them. So they expect you to do their job the best of your ability. And at times, you're gonna have to put a little more effort. Then, you know, when it comes to large companies, they don't care because basically, if you have 5 hours, they're only gonna give you 300 miles. Smaller company will willing to give you more miles because it's a different environment. When you go out there, let's say, you know, the company hires you and you work for a small carrier or medium-sized carrier, you know, as soon as you pull into the customer with their trailer, you basically represent that company. Why? Because one is you're hauling their load. Second, you're driving their trailer and their name is on their trailer. You know, companies expect you to behave and act in a professional manner, which a lot of drivers nowadays, they're kind of like 5-year-olds, they have a little bit of an attitude. So when a company is trying to find a driver, they basically want the driver to represent their company. And you are a driving billboard. You are representing the company on a public road, at a customer, at the border. So, you know, they want you to act professional and respectful. And if there's a problem with a customer, you know, don't like become a loose cannon and do this and do that. You know, there's a protocol, right? You got to deal with it in a diplomatic way to where everybody will be happy at the end of the day. So you can go home and they can make their money. So here's the thing, dispatch, which they dispatch on your loads, they have no control when you're on the road, right? So you basically take all full responsibility. So the job is, when you take full responsibility, they expect you to act, drive, and deal with situations in a professional manner, which represents the company. And that's what small and medium carriers, they look for, right? Large carriers, to them, it's just a number. When I work for large carriers in the US, you know, when you go through orientation, they tell you this and that. And large carriers, the reason they micromanage and they expect you to do those things is because drivers don't know how to behave. And when they don't know how to behave, they implement these stupid rules for everybody because you're supposed to follow guidelines. Small and medium carriers, they expect that you already know that. They basically want you to have common sense and realize that you're representing them and in a way that it doesn't inflict their business in a negative way. So when you pull into a customer, again, you know, you are the ET face and dispatch and running, they don't know what's going on, right? They're not there with you. So, you know, behave. You know, use diplomacy when situation occurs to where you're not able to resolve anything. So make sure you communicate and try to be a driver. You know, you're not a police officer, you're not an ambulance driver. You are a truck driver and your job is to pick up and deliver a load. So make sure you know, do what you've been doing for the last 20 years and do it the best of your ability. So when you work for a company, you know, they hired you and you work and you gotta kind of like follow their rules and regulations. Sometimes when it comes to small and medium carriers, sometimes you have to learn to resolve issues on your own. At the same time, you gotta be in your lane, right? So how do you do that? Well, one is you gotta use common sense, right? You know, if you've been doing this job for a long time, you already know that. But for those that don't know, or they've only been doing it for like 1 or 2 years, and they go from a large carrier to a small carrier, things are a little different. You have to be kind of like self-sufficient. You have to fix stuff on your own. You're not gonna have 24-hour dispatch. So that means you gotta learn how to depend on yourself and resolve issues without being babysit, without being micromanaged, and learn how to fix problems. And I'll give you an example. I had my student with me and we were delivering in Chicago a couple of days ago, and you go to a customer. And some of those customers, you know, especially on a Friday afternoon, guys want to go home. You know, sometimes they careless, they, you know, they misplace paperwork. So I was delivering and they gave me a dog, they unloaded my freight, and suddenly the paperwork got lost. And what do you do? Well, you want to deal with dispatch? Dispatch can't do nothing for you. What they're going to do is contact customer service and they're going to give them the same answer. So they say, well, we need your dog. You know, you gotta move out of the dock. And I said, well, sure, give me my paperwork and I'll move out of the dock. You have to understand, if you leave without paperwork, how can you prove the load was delivered? Just because they can pull your GPS and say it was there doesn't mean anything. There's a reason why it's called bill of lading. There's a reason why they have to sign it. When they say, well, we can't find your paperwork and, you know, it's gonna take some time. And I said, that's fine. Give me my paperwork and I'll pull out of the dock. Now, the reason I involved dispatch is because my next load was 2 hours away and I had to pick it up by 5 o'clock. When dispatch told me, well, you know, they said, well, what was the problem? And the problem is I'm waiting for paperwork. And they asked me, well, why is it taking so long? And I told them because, you know, apparently they don't know how to do their job. So I have to kind of start doing their job by telling them, well, you know, figure out who unloaded me, figure out, you know, what was on the forklift and call them and find out. What's the paperwork? Well, long story short, they found the paperwork. It was misplaced. They signed the paperwork and they said, okay, pull out the dock and we're gonna give you the paperwork. And that's what happened. So you're gonna be facing situations where you can't just depend on a dispatch to fix all your problems. You know, you are out there, you are a driver and you're gonna be faced with problems and you gotta come up with solutions. Usually they're pretty good shippers, but there will be an occasional shipper where they're pretty much space cadets. They can't, you know, something will go wrong. And when that happens, try to resolve it first. If you cannot resolve it, then deal with dispatch. Not every driver has the right fit to work for every company. Just because you qualify on the basic credentials, you know, which is no more than two tickets in one, you know, 12 months. Just because you qualify just for that on paper doesn't mean you are fit to work for this company or any other company. I wasn't a fit to work for Challenger, and Challenger had 1,000 trucks. I don't like being micromanaged. I don't like people telling me what to do every single day. All I'm expecting is give me the load, give me the, you know, give me the paperwork, and the rest I will do. A lot of drivers, they like to be micromanaged. This company here, they don't micromanage you. They expect you to do your job. They expect you that if you tell them, oh, I have 20 or 25 years of experience, then show it. ET is different from every other company, okay? They're not Challenger. They don't have 1,000 trucks. So basically, they expect you to do your job in a professional, safe way. So coming here, just because you qualify on their credentials doesn't mean you're a fit. What they're looking for is someone who knows how to be self-sufficient, someone who is respectful, someone that knows how to resolve issues, and that can run the miles. Large companies, they're not gonna give you all the miles. Small companies, they'll give you all the miles. So if you come from a large carrier, come in here, and if you're not used to running 3,500 miles, well, guess what? You know, they're not gonna give you 3,500 miles. A lot of large carriers, they give you like 1,500 miles a week. And that was my experience with Challenger. That's why after 90 days I left. You know, there are drivers that wanna run hard and there are drivers that don't. Small companies, medium carriers, they'll give you all the miles. So the question is, what kind of environment do you wanna work with and what kind of environment do you wanna be a part of? You know, if you don't wanna work hard, this may not be your best fit, you know, because they'll give you the miles. You're gonna have to make your money, because they're paying you by the miles. If you don't want to make money, then work for a large carrier, because you know, you're not going to get a lot of miles. Hey, this is Callie. Thanks for watching my videos. I'll see you guys on the road.